Hello and welcome to this guide to the trial of the Grand Crusader. This raid consists of 5 encounters. The first one will be the Beast of Northrend. It is a 3-phase fight where you will have to fight 4 different bosses. The first boss will be Gormok the Impaler. The boss himself will only stack Impale on your pet. What you have to watch out for will be the kobolds. There will be 4 of them on the boss's back. Each time he throws one, his damage and the damage of the impale debuff will increase, and the kobold will jump on your head, unless another kobold is already there. The kobolds will sometimes stun you for 2 seconds, and both the kobold on you and on the boss's back will throw firebombs. Now, staying in those bombs will put a stacking DOT, so try not to stand in them. Now, when the kobold spawns, you have about 3 seconds to dot the kobold, and then he will jump on your head, and the only way to kill him will be to use your pet. However, you don't want to kill the kobold while the boss is still alive, or he'll just throw another kobold at full health on your head. Finally, there's an achievement that requires you to kill the bosses without killing a single kobold. To do it, you will simply have to deal with random stuns, sometimes during the fight. So if you're low on DPS, then it's better to do this on 25 man normal. Now, you have 150 seconds to kill Gormok before the next bosses spawn. Be careful, because after a while he will start dealing too much damage on your pet, so either use a quintuple last stand to survive 20 more seconds, or switch pets. Finally, when he's dead, if you already use your quintuple last stand, there will still be the impale debuff on your pet, which means that you better switch pet. Or, if you didn't use it, it's better to use quintuple last stand as soon as he starts getting hit by the 2 worms, which will be the second and third boss of this encounter. The bosses are Acidmoor and Dreadscale. You will want to kill Acidmoor first because he has the most dangerous ability, which is Paralytic Spray. When he uses it on you, you must immediately taunt Dreadscale and then use Deterrence when he reaches you. He should put the Burning Bile debuff on you. Now, if he doesn't, make sure to re-taunt him immediately, because Burning Bile is the only thing that can remove Paralytic Toxin that will stun you for about a minute if it's not removed. After a while, they will submerge, and then the mobile worm will become the fixed worm, and the fixed worm will become the mobile worm. You want to put both worms on your pet, but keep on DPSing Acidmoor, because you really want to kill him first, before he becomes fixed again and starts using Paralytic Toxin again. Although, when he wants to cast Paralytic Toxin, you can always feign death to make sure that he casts it on your pet and your pet is basically immune to it. Once Acidmoor is dead, Dreadscale will enrage but only a little bit, so you will barely notice it. And you simply have to kill Dreadscale before the next boss spawns. Finally, there's an achievement that requires you to kill both worms within 10 seconds of each other, but here again, it's best done in 25 man normal. The last boss is Icehole. He is basically a DPS race. However, his abilities will affect DPS, the first one being the Ice Breath, that will freeze you in place and stun you for 5 seconds. And then finally, there's the Massive Crash. He will stun you, and then he will run full speed at you, Once the stone wears off, make sure to move out of his way, and if you do, then you will have about 15 seconds where he takes increased damage. So make sure to keep your cooldowns for these phases and you shouldn't have any problems with him. The next boss will sometimes put a dispellable dot on your pet, so you can take the Glyph of Man pet. And he will also spawn something called Nether Portals that must be destroyed quickly, so you can also make a macro to target them immediately. The second boss is Lord Jaraxxus. He can buff himself to increase his magical damage done, and he will also cast fireballs that do a lot of damage and put a dot on your pet. This can be interrupted and they can be dispelled with the Glyph of Man pet. Now every minute the boss will create either a Nether Portal or a volcano. The Nether Portal is the most dangerous and must be targeted and destroyed immediately because it will make Mistresses of Pain spawn and you must make sure that only one of them spawns at a time. The Mistresses of Pain must be destroyed immediately too, because they have an ability that will deal 75% of your health as damage, and therefore they must be killed before they use it. If you're having trouble killing them fast enough, you can try to keep aggro on them because they won't cast it on you if you're tanking them. When the boss spawns an Inferno Volcano, you will want to kill it as quickly as possible to reduce the number of adds that spawn, although the adds aren't very dangerous, they will just AoE and melee weakly, and they're more of a DPS loss than a danger. The fight will continue to follow this 2-minute cycle until the boss is dead. There are only two other abilities to watch out for. Legion Flames will put flames under your feet, simply move out from them. And then there will be Incinerate Flesh. It's a debuff that will last 12 seconds and absorb healing. However, while it hasn't absorbed all the healings it should, then your damage will be reduced by 50%, which is very annoying if you need to burst a Nether Portal or a Mistress of Pain. So if you're using a Spirit Beast, keep your Spirit Mans for Incinerate Flesh. Finally, there's an achievement on Jaraxxus that is actually easier on Heroic, but requires you to kill him while two Mistresses of Pain are still alive. To do it, simply put him at low health, wait until a portal spawns, don't destroy the portal, and once two Mistresses of Pain have left it, kill Jaraxxus. Now the next boss is the Faction Champions. It consists of 10 champions, 3 of those are healers and 7 of those are DPS with crowd controls that will stun you, disarm you, or slow you, or incapacitate you in any other manner, while the healers top them off. So no hunter has soloed 10 champions, so we'll actually be doing this in 10-man mode. If you're going for a world first, you can always go back to the Faction Champions 25. On 10 man, you will only have 6 champions, 2 healers and 4 DPS. If you're survival, you can AoE them down. If you're not, they'll be nearly immune to your AoEs, so simply single target them down. First the healers, then the DPS. Next up are the Twin Valkyries. To DPS them correctly, you will need to be attacking the Valkyrie with the opposite color of your essence. So switch to Dark Essence if you want to kill Lightbane and to Light Essence if you want to kill Darkbane. It doesn't really matter which one you're DPSing because they have shared health. However, the whole fight will turn around whether you can interrupt their heals or not. Now the bosses will cast 4 abilities in a random order. Each Valkyrie will put up a shield and then start casting a heal that will heal them for 50% of their health, so the shield must be destroyed and interrupted. However, if it's a Valkyrie of the same color as you that's starting to put the shield, then You will have to switch essence, then DPS the Valkyr fast enough to break the shield and then interrupt her. So it's rather difficult and it won't always work. However, since they do the four abilities in a random order, but they do all four, if you see a Valkyr putting up a shield, then you're sure that the other Valkyr will be the next one to put up the shield and cast the healing. So for example, if Darkbane does the first shield and healing, then make sure that you switch to Dark Essence and start DPSing Lightbane. So as soon as Lightbane casts her shield, you will destroy her and you will be able to interrupt her. The other abilities is the Vortex. So switch to Dark Essence if you have a Dark Vortex, or to Light Essence if there is a Light Vortex. You will have time to switch back again if you need to be in a fixed essence for the next shield. It will also increase your power stacks. Now, your power stacks increase if you're the same color as the Vortex, or if you touch one of the balls of the same color as you. And once you reach 100 stacks, then for 20 seconds you will deal double damage to the Valkyr you're attacking, and it's simply a good DPS increase. It's especially useful if you're going for the achievement that requires you to kill them within 3 minutes, and that also requires you to get lucky with the shields or simply have quick reflexes to make sure that no heal goes off. Finally, the last boss is Anubarak. During phase 1, the boss will put a weak DOT on you, although it will only be a problem in phase 3. However, he will make adds spawn. Now, these adds put a stacking debuff on your pet that increases his damage taken by 200% or something. And so them and the boss will destroy them really quickly. So when they have aggro on you, feign death, and they will despawn. There is no record of a hunter soloing this boss without bugging the adds. After 80 seconds, the boss will submerge. During this time, he will start pursuing you with spikes that go faster and faster. However, if you kill the orbs in the air, it will put an ice patch. And if the spikes reach this ice patch, then the ice patch will be destroyed, but the boss will start following you again, but will reset his speed. However, since you only have 6 ice patches, you will want to make sure to kite him from one end of the room to another each time you use an ice patch to stop him. There will also be adds that spawn and that will put a stacking DOT on you. You must kill them quickly. Once the boss reaches 30%, he will not submerge again and he will keep using the same abilities as in phase 1. However, there will also be a leeching swarm that leeches 30% of your current, not total, health every second, and it will also heal a new barak. So you can put Widow Venom on him to reduce the healing he takes. And the Leeching Swarm will quickly reduce you to extremely low health. And there's no point in healing yourself, because the more you heal yourself, the more you take damage, and the more the boss heals himself, so you will quickly refall at extremely low health. Spirit Bond will heal you more than the Leeching Swarm will damage you. However, the dot will sometimes do too much damage for you to survive. So you must really keep an eye on your health. And if you're about to die, then you have to heal yourself. But really try to keep the healing at a minimum without dying. So that's it for the trailer of the Grand Crusader. Thank you for watching. I hope this guide has helped you. If you have any questions, you can put them in the comments. And see you next time for the big piece, Ancient Citadel.